travel with me.
Hey fellow humans, Mina here. Welcome back to another drive-in talk, and also welcome back to another book review of the Song and Ice and Fire series. This time, this book is split into two parts because the book was so damn massive, he had to split it in two parts, but we're talking about book three, A Storm of Swords, part one, Steel and Snow, part one of two of the Song of Ice and Fire series, Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. Whew, that's a mouthful. I probably made it bigger than it should be. But anyway, let's get into some maybe mild spoilers. But, you know, the series has been out for a while, whatever, you know. Yeah, I really enjoyed the first book in this series. Then I read the second, which was a major slog to get through. But thankfully, something about this one was much better. It's still not a 5-star read, but I had a much better time reading it. The characters, including new POVs, were much more interesting, and I found the situations they found themselves in much more engaging than the previous book. I even enjoyed Bran's POV a little more. I've always hated his chapters, not in all previous books, but especially in the second book. I don't care about the wolf POV, if I'm being honest. It may be fine for some people, but I don't think Martin writes them as well enough for me to be invested. I still think the plot takes a while to get anywhere, but at least I'm enjoying the ride a little more this time around. Now that Dany has the Unsullied plotline, her chapters are interesting again. I've come to realize that she's not the most interesting character, which I thought so before because her POV was one of my favorites in the first book, but the situation she finds herself in. In the first book, we had the whole Dothraki, and they were my favorite thing about the whole book. In the second, we didn't have much, thus her chapters were boring. And she had dragons, but the Unsullied are fascinating, and while we don't see them do much in this book, it's still cool to read about their training and become what they are. I'm curious to see if anything else interesting happens to Dany, because as a character, she's not as interesting herself as I've come to learn. Dany aside, I feel like the writing was somewhat better than in the previous books. And even though there are about 5 million characters, there are like even 20 pages or so at the end of each book naming everyone and their dog, literally, I could still keep track of who was who and who was doing what. I'm pretty sure I saw the show until around this point in the book, or part two of this book, but then I stopped watching. I also haven't finished the series, even though at the current moment it's a reread. I'm curious to see how Martin continues going forward, as the books are known to be not complete, even if the show is too bad for the reviews, so I hear though, for the show. Am I enjoying my reading so far? Depends on the book and character. I'm happy to continue, but I'll admit I'll also be glad to be out of the series jail when I'm done. Also, fun fact, I'm not sure if my copy has some issues with the printer or if this is true for all issues of the book, but I counted like 38 formatting errors. That's a lot. I don't know, it was this weird thing in the book where the font was, and letters were merged or some weird thing. I kept track of them if you want to see what page they are on Goodreads, but like, that part's not as interesting. But yeah, anyway, how about you guys, my fellow humans? Have you read the books or seen the show or both? Let me know in the comments down below, and next week we'll hit up part two of the same damn book because why not? Anywho, that's all I gotta say for now. If you want to keep hearing more about stuff, be sure to follow me on all your favorite socials. Links below. Stay safe and take care. Bye!